Grippeausbruch gab es noch nie.
Diese ganze Geschichte ist sehr viel größer als erwartet.
Chaos.
Wie es aussieht, passiert das gerade wirklich. Man kann es richtig sehen. Komm nicht her. Hier ist es nicht sicher.
So stand ich da. Blickte auf die Verwüstung. In meiner Erinnerung kramend, wie süß das Leben auf der Erde gewesen war. Es gibt kein Vorher. Nur das jetzt.
Ich war zu spät. Oder du warst zu früh. Und dann treibe ich lange, lange Zeit durch eine seltsame Galaxie.
Ich habe dich schon 9-mal gefunden. Vielleicht auch 10. Und ich finde dich erneut. Es gibt keine Rettungsmission. Wir sind in Sicherheit.
Diese verrückte und grauenvolle Zeit war die wundervollste meines Lebens.
And one of the stars is with us today at the Web Talk Show. You may know him from Christopher Nolan's Tenet or Danny Boyle's Yesterday. Very welcome, Himesh Patel. Where and how are you?
Hi, I'm good. I'm in London.
That's awesome. We are happy to see all over the world now, Station 11. What can you tell me? Which character are you playing?
I'm playing a character called Jeevan, who we'll meet in the first episode, who ends up looking after a little girl as the world starts to end around him.
And Matilda Lawler plays this little girl, and she's astonishing as Kirsten. What have you thought when you played the first scenes with her?
Yeah, I thought the same thing. She's astonishing, yeah. I auditioned with her when she auditioned. I was in LA at the time, so I got to actually sort of audition with her in person, and she was just, you know, clearly the one. And she's just so present and hardworking and down to earth, and she's a really special talent, and I'm really looking forward to seeing where her career goes from here.
Yeah, me neither. And her role as well is such a perfect. She knows her way. She knows what to do. She knows what her faith will be. And your role, Jeevan, is like, okay, where I'm going next. And you have such a sweet first scene on a station. And she asks you, what kind of job do you have? And you answer, I'm a reporter, like a reporter or a cultural critic / I had a web. Okay, I don't have a job. It was so sweet watching you do this too. So tell me, how much time did you have to do this scene?
To do the scene on the train station, you mean?
Yeah.
That was a whole night, actually. We had an amazing few days where we were shooting on that station and then another station as well the next day. And we had a train that was our train. So one of the trains going on the line around Chicago that we'd hired, as it was our train. So, but it still had to carry on going round. So we'd shoot on it and then we'd get off and then we'd have to wait a certain amount of minutes for it to go round the circuit and then come back, and then we'd get another go at it. But it was kind of timed out right, you know, just so everyone could like technically get back in. But that scene specifically, it was part of a night shoot. I feel like it was towards the end. It was interesting shooting with Matilda as a child actor. There are some very obviously strict rules in terms of how long the kids can be on set. And then they have like different actors who are sort of then there when, you know, she needs to go off to have a bit of school time or whatever. And I wound up having to do a lot of scenes where it wasn't Matilda in front of me.
Oh.
And it was kind of, it's difficult because she gives you so much. She's such a brilliant actor. She gives you so much. You kind of miss it when it's not there, really. But I'm glad it's all worked out well in the end.
Yeah. And there were some awesome, cool scenes with you all on your own. You get the phone call no one on this planet won't ever want to get. When you got the news, it's done, we're totally fucked off. And then you had right away the panic attack and it looked so good. So have you read the book before or did you just crush yourself into the shooting?
I read the book just before I auditioned. So I got the call when I was here in London, and I was about to come to LA to shoot Tenet, actually. And it sort of coincided that the sort of audition came through for Station 11, and I actually then wound up, instead of doing a tape, I actually went to LA and I met with Hero and Patrick and auditioned for them. This was in October 2019. And in that intervening period, a few days before, and then when I was on the plane, I read the book, finished the book, and really loved it.
Me too. What do you feel nowadays when you hear the words happy ever after in the marketplace?
Yeah, I feel joy, obviously.
Obviously, it's you are on my Good Morning playlist. There have been several mornings I danced to your voice.
Oh, really?
It's from Obladi Oblada from the great 2019 Yesterday. You were the lead in Danny Boyle's music. You were Jack Malik. It was so beautiful. I loved that movie so hard.
Oh, thank you. Thanks. That's really kind. Thank you.
And since then, I was hoping a bit that you will also become a singer and there will be some music out of you. What are with
this? No, I mean, if that film taught us anything, it's the pitfalls of becoming a big music star. So I was kind of like, I'm good. I'll stick to acting.
But you did very well. And I think a lot of people thought so as well. So can you tell me what was on Station 11 the most hardest scene for you to do?
Hardest scene, gosh. There's a scene in episode 7, which I can't really spoil, but it's towards the end of the episode. And yeah, it was emotionally very draining.
So we have to keep watching until that point at least. You started filming in January 2020 in Chicago before COVID, and then you have to break. You were doing a show about mostly exactly like that topic, not that extreme in real life, but at your place. How is it to do such a work?
Yeah, obviously at the time when we were shooting episode 1, we had no concept of what was about to happen. There were sort of faint echoes of it coming out of Wuhan, obviously, but it didn't seem like anything that would spread any further. Of course, then everything happened and we shot until February in Chicago. I think then they shot a bit more in LA. And then we went on a hiatus. We were meant to sort of come back to Chicago in the summer of 2020, which obviously then never happened. So yeah, it was very strange in hindsight, really, for me.
And Station 11 is a very special TV show. You see women with body hair, unusual in everywhere.
Right, yeah. Fair play, yeah.
And you see disabled people with two arms lost. And this is so real. I think this is a very special thing that you are bringing with you. What do you like most about the show?
Yeah, I mean, those things that you've mentioned, I think obviously the diversity within the Traveling Symphony, I think is really brilliant. And though some may see it as a box ticking exercise, I think it's actually something that's just true to life. I think if this were to happen in a city like London, for example, then naturally, the people who would find themselves either naturally immune to whatever happened or whatever, it'd be a wide range of people. So I think that was really spot on. For me, I think, you know, it's the hope at the heart of the story and the joy. Obviously, on paper, this story may seem like one that's bleak, but it really is actually quite joyful, especially the Traveling Symphony. You know, I think, you know, we pick up episode 2, 20 years in the future, and it starts off on a really joyful sort of quite funny sort of tone, really. And I don't think people will be expecting that. And I hope it sort of people really feel that.
Station 11 is out now. You can get all the 10 episodes on Stars Play via Amazon Prime here in Germany. One of the stars is Himesh Patel. Thank you so much for being on the Web Talk show.
Thank you. Thanks.
And you have now an unbelievable opportunity. You can say into your camera what you always wanted to say, but never have said yet. And I'm very excited to see what this will be in some seconds. And you out there, dear audience, you can make the world a better place. Trust me when I say, you just need a smile and time. Because when you see somebody's needing help and there's no one else helping, please be the one, be kind, help. And smile. We see us again tomorrow on the Web Talk Show. My name is Nico Gutia, and now the final words of Himesh Patel. See you tomorrow.
Wow. I tell you, I've literally never said this before. Please watch Station 11. I hope you enjoy it.